46 years ago, two machines left Earth. They weren't designed to return. They weren't built to land anywhere. They were built to leave, to cross a boundary no human-made object had ever crossed before. And now, billions of miles from home, drifting through a void we once thought was empty, they're sending back a message. Something is out there. Not life. Not planets. Not even stars. Something between the stars. For decades, we assumed interstellar space was a vacuum, a cosmic silence, smooth and uniform, like the surface of an endless ocean. But Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 are telling us we were wrong. Space isn't empty. It has structure, layers, ripples in the dark, invisible currents of plasma, folding and colliding in ways we never predicted. And the strangest part? We've been flying through it for over a decade, and we're only now starting to understand what it is. This is the story of a discovery that wasn't supposed to happen. A mystery unfolding in data transmitted from the edge of everything we know. Let's go back to August 25th, 2012. NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California. Scientists gathered around computer screens, watching telemetry data crawl in from a spacecraft more than 11 billion miles away. Voyager 1 had just done something extraordinary. It had crossed the heliopause, the boundary where the sun's influence ends and interstellar space begins. For the first time in history, a human-made object had left the solar system. But here's the thing. Leaving wasn't the hard part. The hard part was understanding what it had entered. Before Voyager, our picture of interstellar space was theoretical. We knew it existed. We knew it was the space between star systems, filled with traces of hydrogen, cosmic rays, ancient light. But we thought of it as a kind of cosmic desert, sparse, quiet, relatively featureless. Voyager was supposed to confirm that. Instead, it started sending back readings that didn't make sense. In late 2012, just months after Voyager 1 crossed into interstellar space, mission scientists noticed something odd. The plasma density, the concentration of charged particles surrounding the spacecraft, was fluctuating. Not gradually, not smoothly, it was spiking. Dr. Jamie Rankin, a physicist who worked on the Voyager plasma wave analysis, described it like this. Imagine you're sailing across what you think is a calm sea, and suddenly the water around you starts to pulse, like invisible waves are passing through, but you can't see what's causing them. The data suggested Voyager wasn't gliding through empty space. It was moving through something with structure. At first, scientists thought it might be a temporary phenomenon, an echo of the sun's influence maybe, or turbulence left over from crossing the heliopause. But then Voyager 2 crossed the boundary in November 2018. And it saw the same thing. By 2020, both Voyager spacecraft were deep into interstellar space, and scientists had accumulated years of data. That's when a team of researchers decided to go back through the telemetry, not just looking at individual events, but analyzing the patterns over time. What they found changed everything. The interstellar medium wasn't uniform. It wasn't a smooth, featureless void. It was layered. Let me explain what that means. Think of the atmosphere on Earth. It's not one consistent thing. It's divided into layers. The troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere. Each layer has different densities, temperatures, behaviors. The interstellar medium, it turns out, works the same way. Voyager's instruments detected distinct plasma structures, regions where the density of particles was noticeably different from the surrounding space. Some regions were denser, almost like clouds. Others were thinner, stretched out like sheets. And these structures weren't static. They were moving, shifting, interacting with each other. Dr. Stella Auker, a physicist at Cornell who led part of the reanalysis, put it this way. We used to think of interstellar space as this silent, dark expanse. But what we're seeing is almost like weather, turbulence, currents, regions of calm and storm. It was a revelation. The void between the stars wasn't void at all, but the plasma layers were just the beginning. As the team continued analyzing Voyager's data, they found something even stranger. Magnetic ripples. Here's what that means. The interstellar medium is filled with magnetic fields, invisible lines of force generated by ancient supernova explosions, the motion of charged particles, the rotation of the galaxy itself. We knew those fields existed, but we thought they were relatively smooth, gentle, like the pull of a distant magnet. Instead, Voyager's magnetometer detected ripples, small-scale disturbances in the magnetic field, almost like waves on the surface of water. These ripples appeared to be caused by turbulence in the plasma, currents and eddies colliding, creating fluctuations in the magnetic environment around the spacecraft. What's remarkable is the scale. These ripples are happening across distances of millions of miles. They're being shaped by forces, stellar winds, cosmic rays, the remnants of long-dead stars, that we're only beginning to understand. And Voyager is flying right through them. One scientist described it as sailing through the wake of ghosts. So where is this turbulence coming from? That's the question that haunts researchers. The interstellar medium isn't powered by the sun. It's not influenced by planets or moons. It's the space between solar systems, a region shaped by the galaxy itself. And galaxies are violent places. Stars explode. Black holes devour matter. Cosmic rays streak through the void at nearly the speed of light. All of that energy has to go somewhere. And what Voyager is showing us is that it doesn't just dissipate into nothingness. It creates structure. One hypothesis is that the turbulence Voyager is detecting is the result of shockwaves from ancient supernovae, explosions that happened thousands or even millions of years ago, but whose energy is still rippling through space. Another possibility is that the magnetic fields themselves are generating the turbulence through a process called magnetic reconnection, where field lines snap and realign, releasing bursts of energy, or it could be something else entirely, something we don't have a name for yet. Dr. Edward Stone, the longtime project scientist for Voyager, said this in a recent interview. Every time we think we understand the interstellar medium, Voyager sends us something that makes us question our models. It's humbling, but it's also exhilarating, because it means there's still so much to learn. You might be wondering, why does this matter? Why should we care about plasma layers and magnetic ripples billions of miles away? Here's one reason. The interstellar medium isn't just the space between stars. It's the medium through which everything in the galaxy moves. Our solar system is flying through it right now, at about 450,000 miles per hour, relative to the surrounding stars. And as we move, the interstellar medium shapes us. It compresses the heliosphere, the bubble of solar wind that protects our planets from cosmic radiation. It filters the particles that eventually reach Earth. It even influences the rate at which our sun interacts with the broader galaxy. In a very real sense, the interstellar medium is part of our environment. And if it's more dynamic than we thought, if it has structure, turbulence, layers of complexity, that changes how we think about our place in the cosmos. There's another reason this matters. Someday, maybe not in our lifetimes, but someday, humanity might travel to other stars. And when we do, we'll have to navigate the interstellar medium. Understanding its structure, its turbulence, its magnetic environment, that's not academic, it's survival. But there's something deeper too, something harder to quantify. For most of human history, we've looked at the night sky and seen separation, distance, emptiness. The stars seemed unreachable, islands in a vast, indifferent void. But what Voyager is showing us is that the void isn't empty. It's woven with invisible threads, currents of energy, layers of structure. The universe isn't a collection of isolated objects floating in nothingness. It's connected. Everything touches everything else, through fields and forces we're only beginning to measure. And somehow, that makes the cosmos feel a little less lonely. Here's the hard truth. Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 are dying. Not dramatically, not suddenly, just slowly fading. Their power sources, radioisotope thermoelectric generators fueled by plutonium-238, are decaying. Every year, they produce a little less electricity. To conserve energy, NASA has been shutting down instruments one by one. In 2019, they turned off the cosmic ray detector on Voyager 2. In 2020, they shut down heaters that kept some instruments warm. By the mid-2030s, both spacecraft will fall silent. They'll still be out there, drifting through the interstellar medium, but we won't hear from them anymore. And yet, in their final years, they're giving us gifts. Every data packet transmitted back to Earth, across billions of miles, taking more than 21 hours to arrive, is a glimpse into a realm we've never seen before. A realm we didn't even know existed. Dr. Suzanne Dodd, the current Voyager project manager, described it this way. It's like watching someone you love grow old. You know the end is coming, but every day they're here, they're teaching you something, and you're grateful for every moment. Let's zoom out for a moment. Right now, as you watch this, Voyager 1 is more than 15 billion miles from Earth. It's moving at 38,000 miles per hour. And in all that distance, in all that time, it has crossed less than 1,000th of the way to the nearest star. The scale of interstellar space is incomprehensible, and yet we're measuring it, with instruments built in the 1970s, with technology less powerful than the phone in your pocket. And those instruments are revealing a cosmos far stranger and more intricate than we ever imagined. The layered plasma structures Voyager has detected, we don't fully understand them. The turbulence, the magnetic ripples, we can observe them, but we can't yet predict them. We're like cartographers in the age of exploration, sketching the coastlines of a continent we've never set foot on. But here's what we do know. The universe is not smooth, it's not simple, it's not empty. Everywhere we look, no matter how far we go, no matter how deeply we probe, we find complexity, structure, pattern, beauty, even in the spaces between the stars. And that suggests something profound. Maybe there is no such thing as empty space. Maybe every cubic inch of the cosmos is humming with invisible activity, fields intersecting, particles colliding, energy flowing from one form to another. Maybe the universe is alive in ways we can't yet perceive. Not conscious, not aware, but alive, in the sense that it's always changing, always moving, always creating something new. Here's the question that keeps me up at night. If we were wrong about the interstellar medium, if this empty space turned out to be layered, turbulent, and structured, what else are we wrong about? Think about it. We've only sent two spacecraft beyond the heliopause. Two data points. And they've already overturned decades of assumptions. What happens when we send more? What happens when we can map the interstellar medium not just along two narrow paths, but across entire regions of space? Scientists are already planning the next generation of interstellar probes, missions with better instruments, faster propulsion, longer lifespans. Some proposals involve using the sun's gravity as a lens, sending a spacecraft to a point 550 times farther from the sun than Earth, where it could observe distant stars with unprecedented clarity. Others envision fleets of small probes, launched by lasers, that could reach nearby star systems within a human lifetime. But even without new missions, Voyager's legacy will endure. Because it taught us something fundamental. The universe doesn't reveal its secrets easily. You have to go there. You have to measure. You have to look. And when you do, when you push past the edge of the known, you'll find things you never expected. Before we end, there's one more thing worth mentioning. Each Voyager carries a golden record, a 12-inch, gold-plated copper disc, inscribed with sounds and images from Earth. Music. Greetings in 55 languages, the sound of wind, rain, laughter, pictures of humans, animals, cities, oceans. It was meant as a message to any intelligence that might someday find it, a snapshot of who we were and what we valued. But here's the irony. The golden record will outlast us. Long after humanity is gone, long after Earth itself is consumed by the dying sun, Voyager will still be out there, drifting, carrying our voices into the silence. And maybe, in a billion years, it will cross paths with another star. Maybe some distant intelligence will find it, decode it, and wonder about the species that built it. Or maybe it will drift forever, unnoticed, through the layered structures and magnetic ripples of the interstellar medium. A message in a bottle, cast into an ocean, we're only beginning to understand. Either way, it will endure. A testament to our curiosity, our hope, our refusal to accept that we are alone, or that the universe is indifferent. So here's where we are. Two spacecraft, launched in 1977, are billions of miles from home. they've crossed into interstellar space, and in doing so, they've revealed something astonishing. The void between the stars isn't void, it's structured, layered, dynamic. It has turbulence, magnetic ripples, plasma currents that shift and collide in ways we never predicted. And the most beautiful part? We're still learning. Every day, new data arrives, new patterns emerge, new questions take shape. What causes the turbulence? How do the layers form? What happens at the boundary between different plasma structures? We don't know yet, but we're looking. This is the edge of knowledge, the place where certainty ends and wonder begins. And it's a reminder that no matter how much we discover, no matter how far we travel, the universe will always have more to show us. So the next time you look up at the night sky, remember this. The space between the stars isn't empty. It's alive with invisible forces. And somewhere out there, two small machines are measuring it, one data point at a time, sending their findings back to a pale blue dot they'll never see again.